that God is radically inclusive. And Jesus needed to tell those disciples very clearly, He's doing it in my name, first of all. And secondly, he's doing what you were not able to do. And thirdly, he's doing it for the kingdom. We shall not stop him from doing this good work. And nor shall we be stopped from doing good work. We don't have to be on the inside of someone else's idea of what church is supposed to look like and or be like to be for God, to stand for Christ. And that's what God was trying to impart through Jesus Christ, that there's no special club. The man is not one of them, should not even matter. And then we go to James 5, and it says it so very clearly. This kingdom project is not going to work if we are fragmented and concerned with our own self-promotion and well-being at the expense of others. Christianity is not a project for individuals. It is defined as community. And it has some very, very profound implications. And as Christians, we are truly to be our brothers and sisters' keepers. And we're to walk together in each other's situations and in each other's pains. We are to serve together, pray together, hope together, cry together, live together, heal together, hope together, love together, so that we might choose to dine with homeless people like a pope did on Thursday. Instead of sitting at the table of privilege. So that we might just choose to be the voice of the powerless, a hand for the hopeless, a witness to the sick, and an anchor of God's love for all of humanity. So that we would not be the stumbling blocks on the paths of righteousness. So that we can be drum majors for justice within individual Christian communities, between churches, between religions. Our salvation is inextricably bound. And it's a good thing. And for the life of a believer, it is the worthy, worthy struggle to continue to walk with Christ and continue to suffer for Christ. And what I'm so